Evening, fellow coin collectors. Coin Snatcher here with another update on the 50p collection. So sometimes you look at your collection and you just realize there's too many spaces in that collection. There's too many gaps. So the time has come to try and fill up some of these holes to try and get some of the coins that have come out this year that I have missed. So there's some of the coins, for example, the dinosaur coins, where I only have one of them. And the reason for that is I'm hoping to pick those up cheaper at Christmas time. Not guaranteed, but I'm prepared to wait until Christmas, see if the price goes down, and purchase them then. So the other spaces you'll see in front of you, there's quite a few. There's the three Winnie the Pooh coins, which need to go in just to the right-hand side of the diversity coin. And there is also the John Logie Baird 50p that needs to go in just beside the decimal day 50p. So let's have a look and see what has arrived today. And of course you'll recognize the box straight away. It's your standard issue Royal Mint Silverproof 50p box. So it's a UK 21 LBSP. So that's a United Kingdom coin, 2021, Logie Baird, Silverproof, minted or packaged on the 28th of April, 2021. So these little boxes are pretty good. They hold the coin inside nice and firm, and I'm sure it does work in stopping the boxes from getting damaged. These little boxes are worth keeping as well, because if you ever sell the coins on, then you can always repackage them and post them on. So let's have a look at the coin. Comes in the standard Royal Mint box now. They all look the same pretty much. 2021 UK 50p silverproof coin. Nice little picture on the end there. And if we pop it round, that's about it really. Not too sure about this character here. It almost looks like a scene from a horror movie. This character here looks a bit strange. This one looks a bit strange. In fact, I'm not really sure what that is. So they looks like they're at the Horror and Science Museum or something. So let's open this up and see what the coin inside is like. So there's the coin. There's the booklet. Let's see if it says anything interesting on the back. So the father of television, John Logie Baird, was a true visionary, and his exploration into the world of moving images changed the world and altered the landscape for both communication and entertainment. From an inventive youngster to a trailblazing pioneer, Baird's contributions to the world of science and his profound influence on technology in the 20th century unquestionably make him one of the greatest innovators in modern history. Innovations in science. So yeah, this is part of the innovations in science range of coins. A couple of other ones previous to this that have come out. I do like this box in some ways, and then in some ways it's too uniform. I like this bit that's uniform, but I think I would have probably had more colour and more pattern on the rest of it. But smart looking presentation from the Royal Mint, it does look nice. And then you have your standard fold-out type leaflet. Now, these I tend not to open up because they tend to get creased and then not go back together again. So there's a little bit about John Logie Baird. And a little bit more. And a little bit more. So I won't go to the effort of opening this up because I'll probably end up creasing it. But we'll leave it as it is. So let's look at the more important thing anyway, the reason why we all get these 50p's. It's not for the leaflet that comes with it, it's for the coin itself. So the coin, if I can get the box open with one hand, that's why it's upside down, back to front. Oh, let's pop that there. Let's open that up. Before we have a look at the coin, let's have a look at the COA. So this is 1847. That was a fine year, 1847. And if we have a look at the specs, all the standard specs there, but always interesting to look at the reverse designer, who in this case is Osborne Ross, and a fantastic job he's done as well. So maximum coin mintage 5010, limited edition presentation 4,000. So as per normal, 10 most likely for trial of the picks, and another 1,000 which I would assume are going to go into a innovations in science set. So I would imagine once the individual releases are finished, then they'll probably release a nice set with all the coins in it together. There's the usual bit of bump that you get in every COA. You can read that at your leisure if you wish. And on the back, you just have the address of the Royal Mint and their little hologram. So that's it for the COA. Let's have a look at the coin. So this coin, I thought, was possibly one of the best designs of the year. I really, really liked this coin. Thought it was really, really nice. So at the bottom of the 50p, you have a television mast, and from that television mast, you have 5 or 6 radiating circles, and each circle has a line of text in it which describes an important point in the development of television. So at the top of the coin inscribed, it has John Logie Baird, television pioneer, and then as you work your way around the coin. So in 1888, John Logie Baird born, 1905, studies engineering, 1926, demonstrates analog television. It's really cool the way this, you turn the coin round and then work up. 1928, first transatlantic transmission, and 1946, John Logie Baird dies. So his birth on the coin and his death on the coin. And where you have the radiating circles coming away from the television mast, they look like they have a curve, like they're countersunk into the coin. So when you tilt the coin, you get that amazing reflection. And of course, the circles that are radiating from the mast are the table bits of the coin, or the frosted bit of the coin, and the mirror image, the reflective bit of the coin, is the bit that really sets this design off. For me, I think this is possibly one of the best designs of the year. It becomes slightly hypnotizing when you look at it. We've got it under decent magnification here, and wow, what a nice coin. Just worth noting as well, just on the bottom of the coin, either side of the tower mask, you have his birth and death, 1888, 1945. So really, really pleased with that. A really nice coin. Big thank you to the seller as well. Picked this up off my channel, funny enough, yep. Guy who watches this and had one spare. He did me a really, really good price on it. It arrived really quickly by special delivery, so can't fault him for that at all. And for a coin that's been away from the Royal Mint for a few months, it doesn't look too bad at all. So really, really chuffed. Thank you to the seller. So we'll get this back in the box, and we will get that box on the shelf over there beside the decimal day 50p. And that shelf will start to get filled, and then the shelf underneath is for the 2022 coins. So that's it for now. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, leave a comment, hit the like button, and more importantly, subscribe to the channel. Peace and love. Coin Snatcher out.